Hello, and in this video, I'm going to show you guys how to purchase a mockup on our website. I'm going to show you from this video how to use the mockup. So you're going to use the mockup to apply your own design on top, and then you can show your customers what your item is going to look like without physically like making a ton of products. So this is kind of gives them like a visual. Okay, so let's get started. So we have our blank canvas. We're going to drag and drop, not this. We're going to go to our mockups. And let's see, where do I have them? Oh, here we go. Right in front of my face. So I'm going to grab the mint, and I'm just going to drag and drop it to my canvas. Okay, so it's a little big. So we'll select that and then resize it down to the size of our canvas. And right now my canvas is just an 8.5 by 11 size. So I'm going to size this to fit right into there. There we go. Okay. Whoa. Okay, so now we have that. Now, we're going to drag and drop a PNG file. What's a PNG file? A PNG file is just a file that has a transparent background. So you're not going to have either the white background or a black background. It's just going to be transparent. So I'm going to grab that. And this is a design I just worked on. So I'm going to put it over there. And then I'm going to resize it and put it right on the top of the mock-up. And I want this to be as realistic as possible so my customers get a good feel of what their shirt would actually look like with this design on there. So then you'll move that around to get it right where you want it, and I think that's good. Okay, you're done. Mock-up's finished. Now you have to save it. So there's two ways to save it. If you have the business edition, that's what I'm working on right now. The business edition of Silhouette gives you the option of saving your canvas right here in different files, like a different file format. Okay. So you go to file. If I wanted to just save this, I would put save selection because that's what I'm selecting. But in this case, I want the whole canvas saved. So I'm just going to go to save as. I'm going to put it to save at to hard drive. I'm just going to leave it right here for now. You can pick the file that you actually want it to go in. So I'm going to put it, and I want to save mine as a JPEG. And I'm going to put test mock. Okay. So that's going to be my JPEG. Now it's going to ask me how many pixels on end to end, what I want, the DPI, which is the dots per inch. This is just saying at a... If you blow this up really big or if you size it down really small, how do you want the quality to be of this image? And since most likely it's going to be uploaded online, it doesn't need to be very big. So I think like Etsy's thumbnail size is like a 500 something by 500 something pixels. So it doesn't need to be very big. So that'll be fine for me. Because again, it's just going to be online. I'm not going to print it out. But if you were going to print it out, then you'd want to run this baby all the way over to like 300. Say you needed to like, I don't know, like you were going to display it somewhere or something, then you would move this over to get the 300 DPI so the clarity is a lot better. But since we're just going to upload it, most likely it doesn't need to be that big. So then we'll save it. So now it's right in my file. Okay, what if you don't have the business edition? So here's another option for you. You are going to file and you're going to press print. You're like, what? I'm not trying to print this out. The print option gives you the option to print to PDF. That's what we're going to press. So you're not technically printing it. It's actually saving it as a PDF. Why it has it in the print mode, I have no idea. But that's what we're working with right now, okay? So you're going to print as a PDF. And you're going to press print. Now it's telling you it's going to save it as a PDF. What are we going to name it? We're going to put test mock 2. And it's going to save it as a PDF in this file that I selected. If you want to change it to a different file, then you can scroll around and do all that. So it's going to save it. This takes a bit to save it, but not too bad. So let's let it save. Okay, great. Now that it's saved. So now let's go back and check them to see how they're looking. So we're going to go back to our files. And we're going to go to test mock. Let's find where those are. Okay, so here's our test mock and our test mock 2. Those are the two that we just created. Okay, so Silhouette doesn't like PDFs, so you can't technically upload it. It kind of gets distorted in lines, but you can open it or you can upload it to, like, say, Etsy or Facebook or something like that, and it would be just fine. So let's open that up and show, like, so you can see what that looks like. Perfection. Where'd she go? There she is. That looks great. So you could upload that to your shop or to your Facebook or just to show your client what her shirt would look like. So there's that. And then let's see how our JPEG turned out. So we're just going to drag and drop our JPEG to Silhouette just so you can see what it looks like. Perfect. Looks exactly like it. So that, my friends, is how you do a mock-up. Super easy. Once you get the hang of it, kind of drag and drop. And I guess the most tedious kind of what you have to worry about is how you're going to save it. And then just make sure that you create a file to, like, a mock-up file so you can create all your mock-ups so you're not, like, recreating them. You have them in a great place so you know where they are. Because those really come in handy to show your customers. Alrighty, guys, thank you for watching the video. Go ahead and check out our website, alwaysblanks.com, for our colored 100% poly sublimation shirts. And our mockups are available there too. Alrighty, thanks for watching.